All right, that breaking news tonight. After 2 weeks without a head coach, it's looking like a new era for the Tennessee Titans.
We begin with breaking news tonight from St. Thomas Sports Park as the Tennessee Titans announced the hiring of a new head coach.
NFL head coaching news. We've got a spot filled Monday. Tennessee Titans have hired Bengals offensive coordinator Brian Callahan to be their next head coach.
The Tennessee Titans, according to Tom Pelissero, has their guy.
The Tennessee Titans, who have now hired their head coach, Brian Callahan.
The Tennessee Titans are making an excellent hire.
The Tennessee Titans have a new head coach. It is Brian Callahan.
This is the man of the hour, Brian Callahan. New head coach of the Tennessee Titans. What is the aspect of being a head coach that you are most excited about?
Oh, that's a great question.
Just the chance, because I believe that I've been capable. I believed in my abilities to lead a group of people, to connect with a group of people. And I think that there's an organization here that feels exactly the same from top to bottom. And that's exciting to me. But that role where I can be the one out front, that I can help bring people together, help connect the team. That's exciting to me. That's what coaching is. It's building those relationships. It's helping develop people.
Why call your own plays?
A lot of reasons. One, I like being involved in the process. That's part of what makes football fun for me is the solving the problems. Two, in today's NFL, everyone's always looking for the next offensive coach. And so just what happened to Zach in Cincinnati, I've left and nothing changes for Joe Burrow. The system's gonna stay the same. No matter who you hire, the voice to the quarterback is consistent. And the dream is that Will and I have a partnership for the next 10 years. And he's the person I hear him every Sunday for the next 10 years. He hears me. The system doesn't change. The verbiage is the same. So the quarterback has a chance to master an offense. And I think that's important because outside of the ownership, the GM and myself, the next most important relationship in the building is me and him. And it's hard to foster that relationship without being involved in the process. And so I believe in that. I've seen it work. You see coaches around the league doing it. But that's the biggest reason why. Is one, I love doing it. And two, there's another part of that process where we want the system to stay the same, and we don't want to lose it.
Brian, one of the first questions you got in your press conference was about Will.
Yeah.
About Will Levis. And had you, I know you didn't need a quarterback because you got Joe Burrow, but had you done much work on him? So you were aware of
him. I was very familiar, very aware. You know, I watch all the quarterbacks every year just to know. But you see the traits. He's big, he's strong, he's fast, he's hyper-competitive. He can throw the ball all over the field. And then he got some experience this year. And so like I said in my press conference, the NFL is a bear on young quarterbacks, and so that learning process is critical. And now you get a chance to step back, install a new system while evaluating what did you do well, what can we do better, how do we improve everything about your game going into year two. A large part of that's going to be he's involved in OTAs and training camp as a starting quarterback.
How quickly do you hope to have a staff in place?
Ideally before the combine, which is plenty of time. I'd like it to be done by then, but it could be done sooner. Just depends on how these things move. But we are going to take our time. We're not just going to hire to hire. We're going to interview people. We're going to get some ideas from around the league and talk to guys that maybe I'm not familiar with and see how we can build the best staff together. There's going to be a combination of veteran coaches, some younger coaches, guys that I've worked with, and I know guys that maybe I don't. And so we're going to try to build the best diversity of thought. And I think that's important on a coaching staff.
Let's wrap up with this. I recently asked Amy Adams Strunk, at this moment where the franchise is turning in a new direction, what is it important for Titans fans to know? So I ask you, what do you want them to know at this moment?
I wish I could bottle up and sell what I felt when I was in the interview on Monday here. And what I mean by that is the energy from the people that I got to talk to, the excitement about what's to come. You could feel the newness of some of the things that were happening. Obviously, with Rand being here and Chad, and there's this kind of behind the scenes energy swell that I felt in the interview that said to me, this fits you, you gotta be here. And this was like the only place I wanted to go. And that's because I felt that. And I hope, and I know they will eventually, but that the fans feel that, see that, that there's some really, I think, some really awesome times ahead. And I believe that in my core that we're set up to have a lot of success.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And welcome.
Thank you. Looking forward to working.